So, ladies and gentlemen, my first remarks are very clear. First of all, the turnout. For the first time, the turnout is going up more than 43%. It's only a small change with the 42% of the elections of 2009. But if for the first time in more than 30 years, we see that the turnout is going up. And in my opinion, that is one of the consequences of the way we have handled this European election. The fact that European political parties had candidates for the presidency of the European Commission, and maybe I hope that we can go further in that direction by having direct elections for the presidency of the European Commission in 2019. My second remark is that, as you know, our group, the Alliance for Liberal and Democrats for Europe, has actually 83 seats in the Parliament, and this projection, this forecast, this poll gives us 74 seats, so that means that we have already secured more than 70 seats in the new Parliament, and that in any way, with this outcome, we continue to be the third group in the Parliament, as we are now for the moment. The third group, bigger than the nationalist, populist, and the Eurosceptics. But we shall try to beaten also this poll that you see on the screen there, this projection. Because we are, besides the 74 seats that we have secured now, also in negotiations in six countries to have an additional 16 seats in these six different countries, securing nearly 90 seats in the next parliament, and by that being bigger than the 83 seats we were in the previous parliament. My third remark is to underline that also in a number of countries, pro-European parties have won the elections. It's not only, don't look only to France. I like France, I have nothing against France. I like it very much. But there are also other countries where the trend is quite the opposite. And the best example of that is certainly the outcome of the elections in the Netherlands, where the pro-European D66 party became the biggest party, together with the Liberal VVD party, and bigger than the anti-European party of Mr. Wilders. And then my last remark is very simple. It's clear that after this battle for the electorate for a few weeks, we need now to decide on the presidency of the European Commission. And I shall repeat what I said in all the debates that I did with my different colleagues the last week. It has to be one of the candidates that presented himself in this election that has to be nominated as the president of the Commission. It is for us unthinkable, and we shall not give our votes in the Parliament to somebody outside the candidates. Otherwise, this whole exercise we did, this whole democratic exercise, is just a little game. And that is not what is at stake in a democracy. What is at stake in a democracy is to build up a majority in this House, and to nominate one of the candidates for that mandate.